I recognise that car from somewhere.
I did.
You all right?
Hey, I'm so organised to precision today.
We haven't got a spreadsheet.
We're all going out. Oh yeah, love. Are we still doing that?
Oh yeah.
What? Dancing?
We're going out
at the church. Sign, sealed, delivered. Like right, so we're going to go. Just follow my lead because we're just going to go out and have a little dance.
Because, like,
because I made it.
You made it.
Unique. £10. Iron on transfers from eBay.
What's it say on back?
Mrs. Sammet.
Have you spoke to Luke?
Last night. Luke is now, at the minute, it's from my dad's house, getting himself sorted. And I'll see him at the church. Next time I'll see him, I'll be at the altar.
And how did he seem when you spoke to him?
He was fine.
Yeah.
He was cold as cucumber. He was like, oh, I'm fine. He did forget the tape recorder last night, which I'd like to point out, get it on camera.
Okay.
I just hope everybody has an absolutely wonderful day. At the end of the day, it's all about having fun, and I hope everyone has a great time. And I'd just like to say thank you, a big, big thank you to everybody for celebrating such a special occasion with us, because I can't wait. I can't wait to be brilliant. It's been great. So thank you.
This is Paul making tea. It's gone 11 o'clock. We're still on schedule.
Right, this is for my husband-to-be. I would just like to say, Luke, thank you so, so much for making me feel like the happiest woman in the world. I couldn't wish for a nicer guy to be my husband and to grow old with, and I'm really, really looking forward to being your wife today. So thank you, and I love you very, very much. I'll tell you something else for the record.
Okay.
Luke wrote a lovely little list out of all the things that needed to remember. Then I noticed that at the very bottom of the list was the word rings, written in a different coloured pen. And I questioned Luke and said, you forgot the rings, didn't you? And he says, no, I didn't forget the rings, my pen ran out.
Little bit, and she popped me a doofy in,
yeah.
And then she says you want it matching, so we matched the bags up. You all ready for your duties?
Yeah. I'm more nervous now than when I got married. I will give
that. Will you?
Yeah, I am.
How are you feeling, Luke?
Fine.
Not nervous?
No.
Wonderful.
No, not yet. I'll see what happens.
So, how many did you have round the corner?
Only one.
And you remember the tape recorder?
Ladies and gentlemen, the bride has arrived. And we're about to begin our service. And so if you'll please stand to greet the bride. this afternoon on this wonderful day. It's so wonderful that we're going to leave all the doors wide open so that anyone passing on the street can hear and see what we are doing. And I now invite Luke's mum and Laura's mum to collect the candles that are lit at the back of the church, to bring them forward and place them on the altar, symbolising the two families coming together, which we will utilise a little later on in our service.
Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
So, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Luke, Laura, I shall now ask you if you freely undertake the obligations of marriage and to state that there is no legal impediment to your marriage. Are you ready freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I am.
Are you ready to love and honour each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I am.
Are you ready to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His Church?
I am.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I.
Why I. Luke John Samet.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To
Laura Louise Scales.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I.
Why I, Laura Louise Scales.
May not be joined in matrimony to.
May not be joined in matrimony to. Luke John Samet.
Laura, take this ring.
Laura, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
There'll be no crying.
Missed the nerves started kicking in as you were walking down.
Did they?
Yep, I could feel it a little bit. And
oh, it's when I was saying the words that really shut
when you
me
started
up.
Welling up, I started welling up.
I know. It was emotional. Not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby.
Congratulations, Lauren and Luke!
Hey!
It's making me sound a bit shy and timid and nervous. Is there any way you can alter it? This guy is quite good on karaoke. Can you alter it to sort of strong, confident, sort of assertive, none of that? After dinner speaker, you know, anything like that? Nothing?
No.
Okay, it's like you're stuck. Well, I'm stuck with that one, aren't I? On-off switch, that's about all I've got. That's my effect, on-off. You were going to get about 25 minutes of absolutely brilliant stand-up comedy tonight. Unfortunately, Peter Kay couldn't be here, so yeah, you've guessed it, you're stuck with me. So, okay. I shouldn't be saying okay all the time, should I? That sounds like I'm being nervous straight away. I know, exactly. So let's cut that one out. Right, we'll crack on. As father of the bride, I get the chance to speak first. There's always a first time for everything. Although Christine has told me I've got to keep this to about 7 minutes. So we've got a sound check at 7 o'clock, so we've got to move on this one. Introduction. That's what it says on here. Let me prompt cards. The people out there, I better introduce myself to start with. There's people out there who don't know me. And there's people out there who probably don't recognise me. To be honest, exactly, in this gear. There's a guy over there, I'm normally something like a pair of jeans and a Pink Floyd t-shirt most of my life, so wearing this type of gear is quite weird, to say the least. I'm Paul. I'm Laura's dad. I'm very proud to be Laura's dad.
Aww, thank you.
There you go. Got that one in. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you all to Laura and Luke's wedding celebration today. Have you all enjoyed your meal?
Yeah.
Great. Well, I've still got chronic indigestion, actually. It's either because I'm worried sick about doing this speech, or I think what Christine says, you just really bolted it down too fast. That's what I'm saying. Right. I hope you've all enjoyed the day so far. I'd like to particularly thank those of you who traveled from afar today to be here, especially Leah and Yannicka. Now, they've come all the way from Malta, I believe. Now, travelled 2,000 miles earlier this week to here, so I really hope you enjoy the day today. I'm sure you do.
Another 500 miles shopping.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly.
In Primark, being away at one shop.
Now, as it's Friday, obviously we also appreciate the fact that some of you have had to take time off work to come here today.
Right.
Is that right?
Right.
He's retired. So it's fair enough. Anybody at all is sick here to be here today? Well,
I think you know
you are. All I can say is, yeah. You're only sticking, we know you are, just enjoy the day, that's all I can say. And kick your face off in the CCTV cameras, otherwise there'll be a tribunal on Monday, a works tribunal, your boss will have you up in front of director. Brings me on to Laura now.
Oh gosh.
It's the moment, Laura. You know what I want to say, and I think everybody will agree. You look absolutely stunning. And the bridesmaids are scrubbed up well. They look fabulous. That's Claire, Christina, the Golden Girls, affectionately known as the Golden Girls, Tamsin and Jenna. I've got to get that one in. I think, those of you who know Laura will agree she's a kind, loving, warm-hearted girl. Beautiful, both inside and out. She's caring and supportive to others, and that is testament to the many special friendships she has made over the years. She takes after a mum for that. No doubt about that. Don't cry, Christine. I think Laura has used her mum as a role model over the years. And they always say, behind every wonderful daughter, there is a great mum. And I thank you for that, Christine.
Aww.
There you go. I don't get that emotional, but I'm going to put you out there at this point. Fair enough. What else can I say about Laura? Well, she came shouting and screaming into this world and has put her lungs to good use ever since. She can talk for England. Just like a mum. But also, Laura, you use your voice for other things as well, don't you, Laura? She does a lot of singing. She does a lot of singing with Lou. But she also does a lot of singing with her, a tribute act called Stars in Your Eyes, which raises a lot of money for charity. Again.
With Becky.
With Becky, of course. And really, again, it's testament to how kind and, you know, how kind and caring she is. She spent a lot of time in Clubland. She's earned a bit of money in Clubland over the years, and with bands. But she said, I want to put something back. And that's why she does this for charity. And they don't make any money out of it, except themselves, personally. All the money goes to charity funds, which is set up. So that's lovely. That's right, creativity. That's another strong point of Laura's. Now, when it comes to creativity, I'll say no more than just look at the tables. Look at the table decorations, everything that's purple, everything, cardboard, it's all Laura's doing. She's creating all the, she's done all the invites, all the invites you got. Laura's created Cardboard City, yeah. Created all the invites. All the table decorations as well. Everything around you, essentially purple, Laura's been involved with at some point. Isn't that right, Laura?
Yeah.
And it looks absolutely fabulous. I really think it does. Right. We've talked about table decorations. We'll talk about music. We'll talk about the music. We'll talk about Laura and Luke in general.
The reason why I wrote this. You've heard me playing the keyboard. Not brilliant. I'm even worse at guitar. But there's a particular actor, friend of mine, well, it's not a friend, I wish it were a friend of mine, but there's a particular actor that's sung a particular song. I want to sing it for her. You might recognise it if you've seen the film. I'm not going to tell you what film it is, but see if you can guess it. If you've seen the film, you'll know exactly what I mean.
Oh, watch out, boy!
Oh, we're getting professional now.
I wanna make you smile when you're feeling sad. Carry around when your arthritis is bad. Oh, all I wanna do is grow old with you. I'll give you medicine when your tummy aches. Build you fire if the furnace breaks. Oh, it could be so nice. Growing old with you.
Like I said a minute ago, you see Phil is 7 foot what? Paul, giant. Laura, scared them more than anybody. I've had to cut it, it'd be nice to be fair. It's really, really clean. Yes. But you're going to show that one?
Sure.
Sorry. To be honest though, I don't think these two are actually perfect for each other. I make such a great couple. I mean, look, they're beautiful together. They remind me so much of the Beauty and the Beast. Right, I'm going to get to the end of this speech now. I've got a few gifts for Luke. I'm going to a crop jar again. Yeah. Just going to get ready and back. First of all, Luke's... When we went on Stagdo, I never realised he was so... You know, but when we went on Stagdo, he had some orders. And the first gift is... It's actually an application form for a night out with the boys. It says the time he's going to leave, the time he's going to get back. And he's not allowed to get back in after that. Yes. Is there? Is it where he's going to? Where he's going to drink? And there's also an important stripper clause. And it says, notwithstanding the female contact permitted above, I promise to refrain from coming within 100 feet of a stripper or a classic dancer. Violation of the stripper clause shall be grounds for immediate termination of a relationship. I'm sorry, mate, well, you know, that's the way it is, but there's one for you. Which is that one. Yeah, it's, you can't read it, you know, it's just there if you want to read it. But, like, it's massive.
There's loads of rules and regs and all that kind of stuff. You've got to get it signed by her and everything tomorrow.
And now we've got the female one. So,
name of girlfriend, fiance, partner, and wife. The first one is, I'm going out. Okay. Sign it, gone. That's it. No more fun. Totally on the phone.
So ladies and gentlemen, please be understanding, raise your glasses. To health, to love, to laughter, to a happy ever after, I give you the bride and groom.
Words fall through.
today.